the driveway pretty much the whole way in. We're supposed to be digging the basement today. It's been raining all morning, so we're getting a real late start on it here. So I don't know if we'll get her done today because it's a pretty big basement. It'll probably take us into tomorrow, which is the weekend, so I'm not real happy. But nothing you can do about the rain. So that's what today's project is. They're all up here excited, wanting to see us getting going here. But we got my brother's up here painting the basement out, checking the stakes and shooting the grades. So I'll get up here and I'll show you a little bit beforehand here, and then when we get started, I'll get a video a little later on. But we got a little bit left to do on the driveway, but we're gonna wait until we dig the basement before we bring it in the rest of the way to the front. And it's been working real good. So that's where the driveway has stopped. Think to the house is probably another 50 feet, but then we'll finish that after we get this dug. Try to get a video here as I'm digging. So let's see what you can see. Then on the upper side, we're really deep because of how steep this hill is. So once we get this dug, I'm gonna have to go around on the upper side. Dig that down a couple feet, like 3 feet, just to get it so it ain't as steep of a bank or tall of a bank, and plus to get it closer to the top of block. So walk out here, and it's just over 2,100 square feet, or no, sorry, just over 2,000 square feet, just under 21. So it should start to go faster. We did, with it raining this morning, we didn't end up starting to dig. So, say probably about 11:35, and so we definitely lost some time there this morning. I think it's about, I'd say getting close to 4 o'clock now, let's see, we're still going here, but it's getting pretty shallow now, so we'll be able to start going a lot faster than what we were, and so we'll see. They actually canceled the dig for today. We got to for Monday, and so it didn't matter that we started today. We actually got some extra time, and so we'll see what happens. Today's Friday. We gotta do some more tomorrow. Hey, it takes a little bit, because like I said, you know, this is only a 135 Evoco, so it's not like we're digging with a 210 here. Yeah, so it definitely takes some extra time because of that. I got my brother-in-law down there looking at me like I'm crazy. Can't figure out who I'm talking to. There you see that back bank there. So we gotta dig that down, I think, about 2 feet or 30 inches, I think. I mean, I gotta step back, so once I dig the top back, it won't be near as bad. The main goal for today is just to get this dug, get some natural drain out of it. Supposed to get some rain tonight and some tomorrow. Usually with this 140, the average 2,000 square foot basement here where we're located, I'd say takes anywhere from 7 to 8 hours, probably 7 to 9 hours to dig. Somewhere in that range. Then it's either really hot out right now, or the air conditioner's not working quite as good, because I'm pretty hot here today. But I got that front window open, that way I can hear better if they yell for me, but... That's the other thing with this basement here. A lot of this is shale rock, which sometimes that can be hard to dig and sometimes not too bad. This isn't too bad to dig, but the problem with it is you get a lot of fluff. So when I try to get buckets, I try to back at the back of my dig. I try to break it off instead of loosening it up and take, you know, it's breaking it off like in a bunch of layers. Because then that way you reduce your fluff on it. We've been talking, debating about what we want to do. We want to get a bigger excavator than this 135, since we have been digging a lot more basements than what we used to. So we're still debating about it. And the problem is, where I'm located, you go to 160 or 170, you're paying top dollar because that's high demand here. It's pretty, those are to the two biggest sizes you can still haul here behind a dump truck. And so you pay a lot for them. You can get a here you can get a used 210 with like 2,000 hours on it for the same price as a 160 or a 170 with 2,000 hours on it. I mean, there might be a few thousand different, you know, but it's nothing dramatic when you're talking about spending $100,000. You know, another $10,000 or better is not an issue. At least it shouldn't be an issue. But the problem with the 210, you have to have a really light tractor and a light trailer to pull it to be underneath our 80,000 pound limit here. And if you're over the 80,000 pounds, then it costs you $250 per trip down the road. And that's just on average. It goes up in price depending on how heavy you are. But when you're digging basements, you can't charge an extra $250 to haul it to that site. That costs you too much money. So we're not sure what we're going to do yet. We've kind of been searching for a semi that's light enough to do this. We'll see. Digging out there, only part of the bucket's hit because this hill's so steep. I got dirt behind me, but the problem is you try to do too much and you mess everything up, and then you're constantly painting your lines. And do is make sure that I'm never really dumping a quarter bucket or half a bucket. I always try to make sure I do have a full bucket, that way to help make time better. That's it for now. I'll get video later on. Alright, we're all done here at the basement. I didn't get any other videos. We've been rained out twice on this. It just has not went real well after that first day there. Which we didn't dig it the whole day. We didn't get it done that day because it got rained out. And so this, we finally got her done now. Because it stopped raining. But you can see it turned out pretty nice. So all the banks are sloped back pretty good for them and stepped back, so shouldn't have any issues with any cave-ins on this or anything. So that's pretty much it.